Good morning, friends. Today we are going to prepare another basic mother sauce, which is called velouté sauce. For the preparation of velouté sauce, we require flour, we require butter, and we require white stock. The stock can be of chicken or mutton or fish. If we are using mutton stock, then the sauce is called mutton velouté sauce. If we are using chicken stock, then the sauce will called we will call it chicken velouté sauce. And if you are using fish stock, then we will call it fish velouté sauce. Now, to prepare the velouté sauce, you will have to take flour, butter and white stock in the ratio of 1:1:10. In the same ratio in which we have taken flour, butter in equal quantity for the preparation of bechamel sauce, but here instead of milk, we are going to use stock. For the preparation of bechamel sauce, we prepared the white roux, that is equal quantity of flour and butter cooked together without changing the color of the flour. But today we will prepare blonde roux. To prepare the blonde roux, you will have to cook the flour and butter together till the flour becomes off-white or slightly brown in color. So we will start with the preparation of blonde roux. Now, to prepare the blonde roux, you will have to melt the butter. Now, in the melted butter, add flour. Once again, I remind you, it is equal quantity of flour and butter. We have taken 50 grams of butter and we have added 50 grams of flour. And you will have to cook the flour in butter till it becomes off-white or slightly brown in color. Now, the difference between white roux and blonde roux is that in white roux, we don't change the color of the flour. We simply cook it with butter. And in blonde roux, we change the color of the flour slightly. Now you see the color of the flour has become off-white or slightly brown. So we will remove it from the fire and we will add stock in it. Now here, once again, you will have to ensure that either your roux or stock, one should be cold and one should be hot. If both the stock and roux is hot, then lump formation may take place and your sauce will become lumpy. Our stock is cold, so we will add a stock. Now, after mixing the stock in the roux, you place it on fire and cook. While cooking, always stir the sauce so that lump formation should not take place. Now the sauce has started thickening, so keep on stirring it till you achieve the desired consistency. Now to check whether your sauce is ready or not, you lift the spatula. Now you see it is not coating your spatula, so you will have to cook it for some more time. Now you see the sauce has become thick, so we will remove it from the fire. Now this is mutton velouté sauce because we have used mutton white stock. If we will use chicken stock, then it will be called chicken velouté sauce, and if we will use fish stock, then it will be called fish velouté sauce. Once again, to store this sauce, you will have to pour little melted butter on top, otherwise a film will form on the top of the sauce and that will make your sauce very lumpy. So I hope after this session you will be able to prepare three types of velouté, that is mutton velouté sauce, chicken velouté sauce and fish velouté sauce. Thank you.